In this video, we'll show you how to create and update user metadata using the Supabase Auth plugin in WeWeb. So here in Supabase, in the Auth schema, in my table editor, in the Auth schema, in the users table, I can see I have a user with the email joyce+1@weweb.io. And if I scroll to the right, I can see that user does not have any metadata. So some users do because they signed up with their Google account, but this one doesn't. So this column raw_user_meta_data is empty. And notice it's a JSON object. So what if I wanted my user to be able to add information, add metadata to their profile? Well, in WeWeb, I could create a user profile page. And in that page, I would put an empty section and then look for a form container, for example, this one here. And in that form, I would put whatever I wanted to. So maybe nickname, item. And on that form container, I would add a workflow on submit. And here, because I have the Supabase Auth plugin installed in my project, and if you don't have that, I highly recommend that you watch our dedicated video on the topic. Here, I installed the Supabase Auth plugin, so I have access to this no-code action, update user metadata. Now, I'll need to tell this action what the email address of my user is. So here I can bind to the user who is currently authenticated, joyce+1@weweb.io. And here I have two options. I could bind a JSON object, or I could just add an item, and here, for example, select nickname. And I would bind the value to the input that I have on my page. So here it's named answer, but let's go back and rename it just to be more clear. So here, instead of calling it answer, we'll say nickname. So when you have several inputs, it helps to rename the elements to make things clearer. And if I go to preview mode, I'll say my nickname is TK, even though it's not. And then back on my workflow, I can see that it is bound to nickname and I see the current value. So now if I test this action, WeWeb tells me that it succeeded. And if I look inside here, user metadata, it does seem like it added a nickname. So let's go back to Supabase and yes, the nickname was added. So that's one option to update a Supabase user's metadata in WeWeb. You choose the update user metadata no code workflow action and select what item you want to update from the dropdown. Another option, which is a little bit more complex, is to send a JSON object to Supabase. In order to do this, instead of choosing an item from the dropdown, we could instead bind an object here. So we could do it in no code or we could do it in JavaScript. I'll start with JavaScript first because it can be easier to read, even though it doesn't seem like it. So here, this is the format that Supabase expects. So what you see here is we are returning this array, this list. And in this array, we have two objects, two items. So you can see them here. And for each item, we are saying the key is favorite joke, the key is favorite chocolate. And the value for that favorite joke key is something about an elephant, and the value for the favorite chocolate key is dark. So now, if I test this, WeWeb tells me it succeeded. And if I go to my user metadata here, I see that I still have my JK nickname, which is a good thing. I didn't erase that. And I also sent information about my favorite chocolate and my favorite joke. So if I go to Supabase, now my JSON object is more complex. I still have the nickname. I also have favorite joke and favorite chocolate. You could do this in no code. So the no code equivalent, what you need to remember is it needs to look like this. So an array of objects. So the no code equivalent would be to create an array. And inside that array, we will want to create two objects. So create object. And we can see for now it has nothing. And here in the object, first the key, then the value. So this is what it looks like. And then favorite chocolate. And now I will say value. I'll change it. This is my first object. And then I will create a new object inside that same array. I created my new object, and again, I need to say, okay, the first key is actually called key, then it's favorite joke. And my second key will actually be called value, and the value will be something about a rhino. So now I have this array with these two objects, and if I test, the user metadata has been updated. Now my favorite chocolate is white chocolate. My favorite joke has changed and my nickname is still the same. So if I go back to Supabase, if I open this again, now the data has been updated. That's it. That's how you can allow users to update their metadata when using the Supabase Auth plugin in WeWeb.